Hello, and welcome to episode 60 of the She Must Knit podcast. My name is Erin, and thank you so much for spending some of your time with me today. I hope you guys had a great week. We had a really nice week. Last episode, I mentioned that we were getting into the long weekend, and it was just a really nice weekend. We had friends over on the Saturday, and they stayed overnight, and we had a really, really nice visit with them. And then on Monday, my dad came to visit. He lives a few hours away, and he's like a bear. He has his annual hibernation through the winter, and then come spring, he you know, pokes his head out and comes around to visit everybody. So he came over and spent the night, and Avery just loved it. She had lots of social interactions this weekend, lots of people playing with her. Dennis's friends who stayed with us over the Saturday, they claimed they were going to be able to tire her out, and they tried, but I swear you cannot tire that child out. So she just had a really nice weekend. And then over the week, I've just been really busy. So we are coming up to a few more shows. I have the Kawartha Fiber Show on Saturday, June 8th. And then I also have a trunk show near the end of June on the 22nd at my local yarn store, which is Unwind Yarn House. So I'm back to trying to get stuff done. This week I had a productive week. Next week needs to be a productive week. So I did get some knitting done this week, but not as much as if I had not had other obligations that I had to do. So it was a really nice week. It was a productive week. I did get knitting done, but not as much as I wanted. So what do I have to share with you today? I have a finished object. I have progress on two projects, and then I'm going to throw in another little something because I did work on that as well. Normally this is a chat week, but I don't have a specific topic I want to chat about, so I think at the end I'm just going to throw out a little question for you guys, and then we'll call it a week. So let's get started. I don't have anything to drink this episode. It is much later in the day. I was running around this morning trying to get a whole bunch of stuff done before the weekend, and so I couldn't record then. It is well after dinner now. I've already had my coffee for the day. Avery is upstairs in her room playing. I can hear her singing. I'm not sure if you're going to be able to hear her. But yeah, I just didn't feel like making another drink. So yeah, I'll manage. So let's get started with my first project. My finished object. I finished my May Desert Vista Dyeworks socks. I wasn't worried that I was going to be right to the end of the month, but I know last week I was saying how I wanted to get the first sock done by the 15th so that I knew I would have lots of time to get the second one done by the end of the month because it is a patterned sock. Well, I did not have to worry. I worked on this most of the weekend. I think I finished the second one by Monday, so in plenty of time. This is the second sock, and last week when I showed this to you, I was up here, so I was able to do all of this knitting over the weekend, and yeah, because I finished them on Monday. This is a pattern that I have kind of developed with help of a stitch book. I showed this a couple of weeks ago when I was talking about how because in the beginning I knew I wanted to do a stitch, but I just wasn't sure when, so I think about 2 weeks ago I showed you the stitch book. I'm using this one here, 400 knitting stitches, and then I found this stitch here. So it's just kind of a twisty cable with a background of stockinette stitch, which I thought would work really well with, you know, your basic sock structure. And I really, really like how it looks. So I did it along the front here, and then I also did it just on the back up until when the when the heel started, and then I kind of split that cable. Otherwise, it's kind of been following what is now becoming my vanilla sock recipe. So I cast on with about 80 stitches, 81 maybe, because I think I did a 2x1 rib. I think I did increase to 82 stitches when I got to the pattern because I wanted to split the front and back to be 41 stitches. I inserted the cable here. I did the leg for about 5-6 inches is what I find I like for my own personal socks. And then I started the heel, and this is kind of the triangular shaped heel that I learned when I did the Jangles sock pattern back in February, and I just really like the ease of doing this heel. I have changed it, I think, slightly from how it is written in the pattern. I've kind of, you know, it's been molded along the way as I've done it over and over again now. I've gotten it to a point where I can do it without looking at a pattern. And I think I might do my decreases slightly different than the original pattern, but I like the result and I like the fit, and it's something I can do without a pattern, so it's all good. But I really like this shaping, and then I did, I think I mentioned before that after I finish all the heels, so basically for the heel, you start here, you start increasing every other row until you get to a certain number of stitches, and then you work to the middle of the heel here and start working back and forth with decreases, and that will bring you back to here till when you have about the same number of stitches again on the back and the front, and then you join in the round and then keep going. When I join in the round, I like to, normally I don't care. It depends on my mood, but if I want the stripe sequence to remain intact, what I'll do is I will just wind off a little bit of the yarn to get back to the correct sequence and then keep going down the foot. And so that's what I did with these. And yeah, so this was the first sock. And then for the second sock, I rewound my cake before I cast on so that you can see that the stripes are going in the opposite direction. This is just something I really like to do with striping yarns, and I've done it for most of my past, or my previous, up for the last couple of months, most of my striping socks, this is what I've been doing, and I really, really like the effect. So yeah, this is my May pair. They are done. I just have to take pictures of them and post them in all the groups for the desert. This is for the Desert Vista Dyeworks Challenge, so I just have to post them on Instagram and post them in the groups. And then we are on to June, and I've got my yarn picked out. I won't show you this week. I think I will show you next week what I'm planning on for that one. But I don't see any problem with completing the first 6 months of this challenge. And, you know, as of now, I think I'm just going to keep going, and I would really like to do the full year again. She makes it really fun. But yeah, I'm pretty sure that the first 6 months won't be a problem. So that is my finished object. The next thing I was working on that took, I pretty much devoted all my time to that project until it was done because I just wanted it to be done. And then once I finished that, I worked on another project that I would really like to have done by the end of the month. And that is my citrine sock. So this is a pattern that fits in with my bingo card. One of the squares that I want to do for this year is to knit a pair of sport weight socks. And so when I decided to start those this month, I looked through my library on Ravelry, because another one of my goals is to use patterns that I already have or resources that I already have. And that my May socks kind of fit into that as well, because that stitch dictionary is a resource that I already had in my library. So for my sport weight socks, I did a search in my Ravelry library, and a pattern came up that I owned, and it's in a magazine, and it is this one right here. And this is from the Interweave Knits, the holiday edition from 2008. So I've made a few changes to these. I really wanted to refer to this pattern mainly for the stitch count, and then I did like the cable. I'll see if I can do that without showing the pattern. It has a really pretty cable down the sides, and I really like that. But I didn't want to do shorty socks, and I knew I wanted to do the ribbing a little differently. There were a few changes that I made, but I stuck mainly to the chart and, you know, the basic recipe of this pattern. The last time I showed this project to you, I was right here. You can see the marker, and I have finished the first sock. So the first change that I did was I did increase the stitch count. In the pattern, the stitch count given was for one size. It was for an 8-inch circumference. And because I knew I wanted to make these socks longer, these I want to be really, really cozy for the winter. I didn't want shorty socks. I knew that that stitch count probably was not going to be large enough for the size of my leg. I like to have a really comfortable leg on my sock, so I did increase the stitch count. And then also the original pattern kind of had a panel of like seed stitch at the front here, and I didn't want to do that, so I just did rib. I did a 2x2 rib so that it would kind of flow into the pattern really nicely, and then I just incorporated, so the extra stitches that I added to the cast on, I incorporated into this stockinette panel at the front and the back, and then otherwise I was able to just follow the cable chart as written. And this ended up being a really, really easy cable chart. It was only 4 rows, and I was able to memorize it pretty quickly. It got to the point where I could bring this. I brought this to Avery's Little Ninjas class this week, and I was able to work on it without referring to the pattern. So it's ended up being a really, really nice knit for that. It's not quite as easy as just plain vanilla, but it is definitely easy enough. So I followed the leg, I followed the chart as is. The pattern is written to have a short row heel, so I just did my normal German short row heel. And then I just continued down the foot. I forgot to mention with my May Desert Vista Dyeworks socks, but this is something that I do with all my socks. I usually start with a bigger number for the leg, and then after I do the heel, I decrease down to a different size for my foot. So if I'm working with fingering weight yarn, like my May socks, I'll start with about 80 stitches for the leg, and then after the heel, I'll decrease down to about 70 stitches for my foot. So I did the same thing with these. I don't remember what the numbers were exactly between the leg and the foot, because this is a sport weight yarn, but I did start with a larger number for the leg, and then after the heel, once I joined in the round again, you can kind of see right there, there's some decreases. So I decreased down to a smaller number for the foot. And overall, these were really fast. I think I was able to finish the foot, most of the foot within a day. So the second sock should, that's a lot of S's, the second sock should not take too much longer. And I've said this before, the best way to avoid second sock syndrome is to cast on right away. So that is what I did with the second sock. I've got the cuff, just the ribbing part, cast on, and this is just ready to work on when needed. I think I just have maybe another, you know, this amount of ribbing left to do before I can start the stitch pattern, and then it should be fairly straightforward on from there. If I get the opportunity to work on this at all over the weekend, I should be able to finish this by the end of the month. That would be really, really nice, because last month I think I had my lowest amount of projects finished for the month to date this year, and I would like to have more projects done for the end of May. And so right now with the May Desert Vista Dyeworks socks, I'm at 2 projects, and if I can finish these, that will be 3, and we'll see if I can, you know, somehow squeeze some other finished projects in there. But I do have a show to get ready for, so I don't know how that will go, but that is the progress on those. I am enjoying those. I cannot wait to have those done. The yarn that I am using for those is one of my own yarns from my shop. A while ago, I purchased some merino wool and nylon, not super wash, sport weight yarn, and I thought it would be just really, really nice yarn to make some squishy, squishy winter socks. I would really like to have them to layer over my regular knitted socks when it's really, really cold, just for extra warmth, and I think they are going to be perfect for those. As I've been making them and as I've been trying them on for fit, I have been trying them on over other knit socks, just so that they have enough room to kind of accommodate those. So I am looking forward to having those in the fall. So I'm going to squeeze in one more quick project before I show you the other project that I have been working on. So because I have finished a bunch of socks lately, I wanted to keep up to date on my Cozy Memories blanket and decided to add the yarns in before it got. I didn't want it to get to the point where there was a big pile of yarn and then it would be overwhelming to add in, so I thought I would just get that done while I had. There was one evening where I didn't really want to work on some of the other projects that I had, so I thought it was a good time just to put some memory squares into my blanket. So the last time I showed it to you, I had this square done. This was from my April Desert Vista Dyeworks socks, And then the next pair of socks I finished were my sample socks that I was working on in one of my deluxe sock sets. And so I made this square. And if you remember when I showed those as a finished object, I had mentioned that I had very, very little of the main skein left. And you can see this is all I had. There is like one row, that yarn right there. There's one row going along the edge there. That is all I had left of that main yarn. I think I was able to do two rows in the garter stitch. And then I went into the purple because there was the two contrast colors. I didn't use all the purple, I didn't use all the orange, I just wanted both colors in the square. So I worked with the purple for the majority of the square and then I switched to the orange. So this square represents my sample socks. And then I was able to put in the square for my May Desert Vista Dyeworks socks. So this blanket is all up to date. If you are new to this project, this is about a 2-year-old project. I am working on it with just all my leftovers from fingering weight projects. And then whatever I have left after putting a square in this blanket is going either in my granny stripes blanket, and then also I am winding off 10 gram balls for the advent swaps that I'm doing this year. I'm doing 3 advent swaps. So I will pull off some of those for my advent swaps, and then if I have like little oddballs, they'll go into my granny stripe blanket. I am working on this for Avery. It is a project that I'm hoping will be done, and by the time she leaves the house, it'll just be something nice that she can take with her. And then I am doing for my stitch count for this size of square, I do 54 stitches, so 27 stitches on each side of the marker. So yeah, I will just be making a gradual progress on that as I go. I'd like to keep up with it over the year so that by the time December rolls around, I am not putting too much work into that and I can devote most of my time to the granny stripe blanket, which is what I am going to be putting all my advent swap minis into. The final project that I have to share with you is the progress on my Cumulus blouse. I had showed this last week. The progress on this is very slow going. I said I was going to work really, really hard and try and have it kind of to the next stage. So up until this point, I've just been working on the increases to create the V-neck shaping and then also the raglan increases, and it just seems to be taking forever. I worked on it and I worked on it this week. I mean, I was working on other things, obviously. But I finally got to where the V-neck shaping is done. So if you can see there, there is a join. I have joined the V-neck. All the sleeve stitches are still on the needles. I have moved all my doodads. So last week I had all those little like bulb markers along the V-neck edge because I was using those to count the rows, because I had to do V-neck shaping every 4 rows and then raglan shaping every 2 rows. So I had all my little bulb markers along the V-neck. Those have been now moved to one of the raglan areas right here. You can see I've got 2 there. Based on my stitch count right now, I have about 3 more increase rounds before I can take the stitches off the sleeves. So I am so close. If I can work on this tonight, I might be able to get it to where the sleeve stitches get taken off. And then it's going to be just working around and around and around and around on the body. So hopefully, it would be nice if I could get to that point for next week where I'm working on the body and I can just work around and around. Because there, I mean, this is the sleeves here. From this marker here all the way to this marker, those are the sleeve stitches. That's a lot of sleeve stitches. So once those get taken off, I think the rows will go much quicker and I'll be able to see progress much faster. Right now, it just seems like I'm putting all this time to it and it's not changing, but I feel like that will change. Last week, I also mentioned how I hadn't checked my gauge on this project yet. I finally did that. I took a moment before I joined for the V-neck and I checked my gauge. And we're all good. I've got perfect gauge, and I just wanted to show this to you. I know this tool is not anything new on the market, so I'm sure many of you are aware of it, but it was really handy. So this is the Ann Budd gauge. It's just a little gauge ruler, and what's neat about this is that it has these little stitch designs on there And all you do is line this up with the stitches of your project, and whichever one lines up perfectly with your stitches, that's your gauge. So the gauge for this project was 18 stitches per 4 inches. So if you take 18 and you divide it by 4, it was like 4.5 stitches per inch. And that is this one right here. It says 4.5 stitches for 1 inch. And when I laid that on the stitches of my garment, each little V lined up perfectly with these little V's. So I took a picture and I'll insert this here so that you can kind of see what I'm talking about. But yeah, this is really, really handy. If you don't have one, they're actually not too expensive. I think I originally got one on Etsy. I've seen them at yarn shops now. They're just a handy little tool. And they do have like your regular ruler up there as well, but they're just a handy, handy little tool. So my gauge is all good. I am still working on the first two balls. Like, these are still the first two balls. This is, I would guess, approximately a lace weight cashmere that my dad brought me back from China when he was there a couple years ago. And I am still on these two balls. I have so much of this green yarn, and I was like, oh, holding this yarn double, this is going to be the perfect project to just use up a whole bunch of this yarn, because I think I have a lot of this green yarn. And I'm still on the first two balls, so like, I'm thinking maybe if I'm lucky I'll use 8 balls in this sweater. I'm still going to have so much left over. But that's okay. I'm just happy that it is getting used, and I really, really do like it for this project. Like, I really do like the fabric that I'm getting. This is going to be a really, really nice sweater to wear, I think. So I'm happy with the progress on that. So that is all the knitting that I've done this week. Like I said earlier, this is normally a chat week, but I just didn't have a specific topic that I wanted to talk about this week. I am working on a few ideas, and I'd love your feedback. If you have anything that you would like me to talk about in a chat week, comment below. I am working on another 10 random facts. I've done a few of those, and they are really fun. You guys seem to like them. I am also working on a chat topic of some of the tips and some of the things that I found really helpful in cutting back certain things from my everyday diet. I've mentioned a couple of episodes that I've made some changes over the last couple of months, and they've made a really big difference. So I wanted to do a little chat about some of the things that I found really helpful in terms of cutting out sugars and just unnecessary carbs from my diet. But I'm not quite ready for that one either yet, because I'm still gathering my thoughts. I'm still making notes and stuff like that. So that will be coming if you guys want to hear it, but not this week. So I thought this could just be a question week. So again, the first question is if there's anything you would like me to do a chat week on. And then the second question, you know, I think I would just like to know, because I've been thinking about this a bunch this week, especially with the projects I'm working on. Like, I am really happy with the projects that I'm working on, but in looking at my bingo card and in looking at the projects that are kind of on the horizon, there's some that I'm really, really excited about. So I would love to know what projects that you currently have that you're just really excited to start. So you haven't started them yet, you're probably working on some other things, but they're projects that are like in the near future, that, so not like dream knitting where you would love to make them but you probably never will. Like, these are projects that are very, very close to being started, but you're just not there yet, but you keep thinking about them because you're really excited about starting them. What projects are those? So what projects are you just really excited to start, but it's not that time yet? So for me, there's two projects on my bingo card that I feel like I'm going to be able to start any minute, like very, very soon, but just not quite yet. And that is, one, my hand-spun socks. So that is a goal on my bingo card, is to make a pair of hand-spun socks. I have a ton of hand-spun, and I don't tend to knit with it, and that's the reason that I put that goal on my card. And I do have a few skeins that are suitable for socks, and I have just been looking forward to this all year, is to actually starting a pair of hand-spun socks. So that is definitely a project that is on the horizon. And then the other one is, there's this garment, and this actually wasn't even planned. Like, when I was making my goals at the beginning of the year, while the goal is something that I planned, one of my other goals is to do 5 adult garments, this specific project was not even on my radar. And then I saw it in the Blinger String group. So if you're not a member of the group, there is a thread in there for just sharing your monthly, it's like a monthly show and tell thread. So anytime you finish a project in the given month, you can post it in that thread, and then I do a draw for a little prize at the end of the month. And it's fun to watch. I love going in there, and I mean, I have to go in there because I keep track of the entries. Even if you don't end up entering anything, just going in there and seeing everybody's projects, you find a lot of patterns that you may not have seen otherwise. And there's one pattern that when I originally saw it, I thought it was nice. I think it was Sandy. She knit this, and it was like this little short sleeve twisty layering thing. So I'll put up a picture because I'm definitely not explaining it very well. But when I first saw it, I thought, oh, that's cute, you know. And then she said it was very easy to knit. And then the more and more I've been thinking, it just seems like it would be a really nice project for the summer and a really nice project to wear over the summer. And I actually do have some yarn that I think would work really well for it. And we all know that I'm trying to use my stash. And then the final little nail in that thought was I recently purchased a black jersey, just a very simple tank style black jersey dress. And there seems to be a real trend going on right now with wearing more like cropped garments with a dress. And that's never really been something that I thought I would be able to wear. But when I got this dress, I thought, you know what? I think it would be really cute if I had like a shorter, because usually I'm all about the tunics. But if I had a little shorter layering piece to wear over this dress, and especially something as airy as this looks like it would be a very airy piece, I just think it would look really, really cute over this black tank dress. So I am just itching to start that. I'm working on my cumulus. I definitely want to finish my cumulus so that is ready for the fall. But I feel like as soon as that is done, I really, really want to make this little twisty layering thing. I just think it would be really, really wearable for the summer. So those are the two things that I am just itching to cast on. I see them in the horizon. I'm really excited about them. I'd love to know if you have any projects that you are really excited about starting soon. And I think that is it for this week. I know this was a shorter episode, but just wait till next week because it is the end of the month. And at the end of the month, I usually do my monthly goals update, and it's also going to be a collection week and stuff, so there'll be lots to talk about next week. But for now, that is it for this week. I hope you have a wonderful weekend. I know if you live in the US, you're going into Memorial weekend, so it's your long weekend. I hope you have a fabulous time. I hope you get lots of crafting done, and I will talk to you soon. Bye.